guys, going to give the lower bracket a bit of attention, and we're going to jump straight into the deciding match between Fluffy's Bizzare Adventure and Like a Sir. They've played two games and tied one apiece. We've got Miss Apples as Great Britain and Fluffy Sensation as Britcom. On the axis, Like a Sir, Volta as Japan, Grey Goose as Germany. So both these teams have no more chances. Whoever loses this is out of the tournament. As we see, Grey Goose going in assault squad. On the left-hand side, Volta with a regular as Japan and regular squad from British Commonwealth. And Miss Apples going the favorite elite MG call as Great Britain is going to meet the German assault squad in the center. Let's see how they go. Those two rifles should do okay in this engagement. Been quite far. A lot of the other people in the squad aren't firing back. One guy may get picked off. The STG-44 guy is in the back, being used in hold fire. Interesting. Looks like he's using it very carefully. The MG sandbag is up and now should be able to hold the center, but the Volta Type 99 MG has killed one of the SAS soldiers. And I think eventually this guy's going to get outshot. Type 99, STG-44, all aiming for it, and it's down. So only the elite MG guarding. And those rifles in this, on this sandbag position may be able to pin this guy down a bit. But I don't think it will do too much damage at this stage. I think center's going to be uncapped for a while with all the MGs on the outside guarding the point from being charged. So perhaps a sneaky cap later on. But Grey Goose now being assaulted. He sent one guy to cap that. But Fluffy straight away with the quick assault squad opening. Regular sandbag as well on the southern point. Now it's really got this guarded quite well. It's quite far though. Allows the Grey Goose to come out from this way and cap without the guys in the sandbag firing at him. I'm going to send an assault squad to contest that point once again. A recruit squad from Volta. The engagement on the eastern point, we see Miss Apples getting up some sandbags and a full assault squad coming in to fight off a regular, which is very interestingly spaced, has a few lines of the sandbags, MG in a position of, as well, and they should be able to take out this assault squad. No problem with the cover they have and the firepower of the MG, but I don't know, this map's got an interesting elevation. They can pretty much cap below that rake and that tractor and be oblivious to the fire. As you can see right now, Miss Apple sneaky capping that flag. Volta cannot do anything about it. Recruit squad coming in from the flanks. We won't do too much. They're just going to get shot up very easily with their low HP. In fact, though, that a few guys had a few lucky, a few of the rifles had a few lucky shots, and MG's actually repositioned on this hill. This is another MG. Interesting buy. That must have been a single MG, and they've been totally outshot this assault squad. And now some of the recruits flanking. More can go down and they should actually get this northern point. Perhaps they can get a few guys on the rake and consolidate the position even more. Blackwatch, one specials are out from Miss Apples. Ooh, King's African Rifle from Fluffy Sensation, all going into the center. Gonna support the elite MG who's done well so far. Looks like he's held off the center attack, and now the King's African Rifle's storming right into the flag. I don't care. Not much fire on them. The MG from Volta has been repositioned to the east. That's what allowed him to get it, but this has made center a bit more vulnerable to attack. Looks like the Blackwatch is actually going to the eastern point now. Volta coming into a nice ambush position just below the hill, waiting to take out the Blackwatch if they come, but they won't dare now. Forced to prone. Now a grenade to follow up from Volta. Zenko Usugi. Usugi. I don't know how you say it, sorry. SMG guy, none of them hit, but this AT grenade will take its mark. Takes out two. Blackwatch forced to stay out in the open. Olikondo is out. This needs to make sure he doesn't get caught with his pants. And Volta with a few SMG guys, they may get through. One grenade. Volta, can he mark us in time? Olikondo, can he take it out? Oh no, Olikondo doesn't take it out in time. The one grenade hits its mark and it damages it. No, it won't destroy it. It'll take out the crew perhaps. Just takes out the crew. Oh, but Volta still has a guy, yeah? And he will take it out with the AT grenade. Bam! Wow, nice pushing by Volta, and Fluffy Sensation caught with his pants down. Definitely should put a belt on Mr. Fluffy, as Volta is coming to, coming right behind you and is going to perhaps give you a big push where the sun don't shine. Miss Apples Well, sorry, not Fluffy. Miss Apples, in fact, is getting the poo-pushing styles. Vault coming in from the flank. Gonna cap the spawn flag, and the pressure is on Fielder Sherborg. Very wide map, and actually quite hard to push the spawn flag because it's very open and counters can easily be bought, but wow, Walter is really putting it on. Walter also with the Hargo coming out, but nice Crusade AA by Miss Apples will do the work quite easily and will take a nice easy 20mm side shot. But from the side we have a 6-pound 80 gun which may get it. Oh no, Walter took out the 6-pounder of Fluffy Sensation, and that Crusade AA should have fired much sooner instead of firing at that guy. And they lost 6-pounder and all econ. That's pretty much their start buys, their first big buys. Both of the players, both of the New Zealanders have lost it. So, gonna set them back a very big time, a lot. 13-3. They are in the lead though, miraculously. I guess they've been holding the center. And Grey Goose with the flak in the center is gonna be, gonna be quite uncountable for now. Crusade AA takes out the tractor. Now another 6-pounder from Fluffy after losing that one to a Hargo, which it should not have lost to. Side shot from the crew AA will be able to decrew that flak without being in danger itself. Sniper out by Grey Goose, better watch out. Better not be too conspicuous with this fire. Too obvious, I mean, as it will easily get shot up by the 20mm. At the backfield we have the Chihi out from Volta, standard buy counter for the Crusader AA. Oh, there goes a sniper. Gregus had it right in the open with the Crusader AA on the field, and that's gonna hurt them as well. A German vet sniper down. Chihi though is kind of in free reign right now. It's tracked the Crusader AA, I believe. It's not moving. It's now definitely tracked it. 6-pounder is not in wait, and unfortunately, at least the 6-pounder did take out the flak I just saw with his HE shell now backing away, but wasn't in the right place at the right time to counter the Chihi. It's a good combo though. Good combo. Been the Crusader AA and the 6-pounder. Using the crew AA as the bait could have definitely worked in their favor. Fluffy holding his flag still, but really his infantry on this side has been worn down. There isn't too much guarding it now, and can be assaulted in my opinion. Center. Looks like the elite MG has perished from something. Now Volta able to storm in and cap the point. I think he's got the home guard as well right now. Yep, home guard MGs are being placed. Fluffy with the King's African Rifle. 6-pounder from Miss Apples. They love the 6-pounders. 2 6-pounders on the field so far. But you have to watch out versus Japan. With the mortars, emplacements are quite a risky buy. Mortar. 2 special point. Gun carrier mortar by Fluffy. Quite a hard map to make it work due to not much cover. I guess he has this very small hill. If he stays behind though, the range isn't that great. I suppose you can even move the mortar carrier down this way and use this hill too, so there are opportunities, but now it's in the open, very dangerous. He's going to try to take the sniper, I think. Where is he going with that? Yes, he is. He's going with that straight to the sniper, trying to take it to priority target, missing all its shots so far. Sniper realizes this is getting knocked out and will move to safety. Grey Goose scurrying away to a new position, ducking, hoping he's not spotted again. Very sparse infantry cover, infantry spread from the allies. Only one King's African Rifle guy guarding this point with this Webley. The right Black Watch. 6-pounder. Walter with the Type 92. Gonna sneak away. 6-pounder, unfortunately, can't take a shot down the hill, and it will take out the MG of the Anzac. SMGs following up, flamethrower as well from Volta. 6-pounder from Amis Apples, waiting patiently, but his infantry support and cover is getting mowed down. Only one guy left, and it's free reign, free approach. That 6-pounder, once it's spotted, it's doomed. Yep, Miss Apples scared, gonna pull back. Now, flamethrower support infantry going to get it. He's running straight at it. He's got his AT grenade as well. It's in his hand right now, and he may be able to take it out. All econ ready to fire. Can it go in time? Throw. Too late. Oh, but lucky. It's just being decrewed. Look at that guy fly. Jesus. Wow. He flew at least 50 men of war meters and skidded on the ground. Taking the 6-pounder back. Lucky. Good combo to have. All econ 6-pounder, but Walter using this heal so well. If he just goes down again, that 6-pounder will be hard pressed to take a shot, but no, too late. Chiefy's gonna go away, trying to take a fire shot from the ground, and will escape. We'll escape into the fog of war. 19-13. Starting to come back. Like a sir has taken the lead. Center is the flag in contention. Anzacs have taken it back for the Allies and have demolished the center position of the Axis, so they've got that quite strong. But this flag here definitely can be assaulted. We've got the paratrooper squad in the back by the Germans are Grey Goose, Fluffy with a few Anzacs just holding. Mortar in support though, still not sure if it's done too much. Doesn't seem to be doing much at all. Crusader AA top scorer, classic 20mm. Olicon flying away. Cheese waiting for the shot, but sorry, 6-pounder is waiting for the shot, misses it. Cheese gonna go for the 6-pounder, misses. Oh, that was a nasty side, but I think its turret may have been felled. Shot misses again, maybe just crew injured. It seems like it's going for another shot. Volta with a shot, 6-pounder, misses. Who was gonna get the shot off? Apples, his nerve has been tested. He's got the main gun, he's safe. Don't know why he moved there. Bit of panic there, but gets the hull damage. And hopefully he does finish it off so it doesn't get repaired to bite him in the ass, as we've seen in the other games. Arc track by from Fluffy, classic counter. Nicely done for the paratrooper, counter for the paratroopers. And yeah, that's gonna get mowed down. Wow, what that paratrooper's got wasted by Panzerfaust and Grey Goose. Misses its mark. That's gotta be at least, oh, that's gotta be max range. That's pretty damn far. As he holds onto this point with just the half track. Mortar, very, very open right now for a shot. Anything can hit, even that flak. But I guess now that flak can get targeted by the mortar. Mortar has longer range, 110, 120 or 110, 120 I think at direct control, if I'm not mistaken, for that gun carrier. Center being capped back by the Axis forces, 21-19. Very even. A bad start for the Anzacs, but yep, now crawling back into it. Taking the majority of cap once again on the right. It's just a sneaky cap though. Looks like Walter does have the majority of force, but I guess the firepower is all, it's all about the Olicon on this map right now, on this side. But the answer's here. The 150mm mortar from Walter, the Japanese 150. Counters emplacements outright, bam, there it goes, 6-pounders next. And that's the problem going in placements versus Japan. You've just got to be so careful with them. Or don't buy a lot. Don't buy them at all. It's, yeah, it's bound to be one-shotted. Wow, MT4A4 by from Fluffy getting the light tank rush. Interesting play. What's he going to go? He's taking out a few infantry, but now going up the hill. A bit dangerous for him, but he's going to run over the mortar. He's going straight for the mortar. What else is there? Nothing is there. He's going to run him over. Oh, 18 rifle. Doesn't matter. He runs over the mortar. Fantastic rush by Fluffy Sensation. Brilliant British Commonwealth action right there. Light vehicle, ragtag force. Quick light infantry or light vehicle tactics. Bam. But dies to the 80 rifle, but well worth it. Killing the special point 150mm. 6-pounder survives that assault, though the northern east is so strong with Japan presence, infantry-wise. Nice shot by that guy. Center, it's anyone's flag at this stage. Perhaps going to go to the Axis shortly, as there's a lot more guys in cover. The one grenades may change this. The Australian rats, this is of the rats of the book coming in. A bit more hit points than normal. Two SB tier, 30 infantry, just lack the firepower with only shitty Enfields. Assault, mortar. Does minimal damage, unfortunately. Hits there and does nothing. This guy, all the ammo in the world. Just a rifle guy with a KR98. Probably doesn't need it, but probably meant for that sniper. 2-2-2 swinging on the far west, going to try flank this point. Grey Goose has capped it, so I guess he's just there to just hold. Come out for an ambush. He's got the hill here to protect it, protect him from an easy shot from this way. Gun carrier. Wow, look at the amount of firepower in this area. All he can be pushed on the hill. 150mm mortar. Boom. The next one he buys. I'm guessing he's going to buy another one. He has not. Volta's gone to Chiha. He's gone to Bunzai Call. One going to the right. A couple of them over there. And don't mind the Soviet flag. It's a bug. Should have the rising sun flag. Communists have taken over Imperial Japan in the mod. Charge! Banzai for motherland! 6-pounder. Oh! Oh, that Chi He's still not taken out, so he's got to take it out. 6-pounder. We'll take it out. Olicon placed in the same position where it did so well, and because there's no 3SB mortar, it's going to be hard to counter. Flanked by a few SMGs. Chiha at the back still. 92 at the back still. Center held by Leica Sir. 34-19. Fluffy and Miss Apples doing okay. They're going to try flank the western point. Mortar coming in, being more aggressive. Hasn't been doing too well. Looks like it's going to try to take out the sniper. Perhaps the Olicon will be better placed to just fire shot it. Oh no, the Chiha's going to take out that mortar. What is it doing? 6-pounder is not in the right facing position. There goes that mortar. 2-2-2 actually takes it out from the side. Olicon can place down, take it at 2-2-2, it does. Jihad will get taken out as well. Payback for that mortar. Sniper has been taken out too. Anzac's doing very well, taking out expensive units in succession, quick succession. And they have the units on to take out. Have the units on the field to take the western point back. Olicon is uncontested. On the eastern, huge Japanese presence. Olicon now placed down. Flank hit, or 6-pounder takes out the Chiha. Interesting, the Olicon's been quite inactive supporting this point. Must be some strange hill right there. Perhaps put the Olicon right on top of the hill. And then you can, if it gets shot at, it can waltz down to safety from a tank. But this is a bit dangerous, placing it in the center. Flank may happen. Grenade being thrown very far. Oh wow, it's taken it out. Because he's on the higher ground, he can throw the grenade a bit further than its maximum range, and that's, yeah, that was way too close, hey. Definitely the heal right there, then just duck right down if the tank comes. Come up, has full reign over it.
Yes sir.
The downside of having it too low there. Type 92 coming up. It's very close to the 6-pounder. 6-pounder has potentially two shots. If it misses both, it's dead. One miss. Volta not reacting, so it should be an okay put away. Type 92 could have rushed it, but never mind. Cheeto is actually in the background. One shots the 6-pounder. And the eastern point is now clearly in Axis hands. Center. Still capped by the Australian rats. Defense wise, okay, Olicon's still there, 6-pounder is still there, and Western Point, wow. The Allies could really push up and infest the below the hill here if they want to. A very small presence of Axis, only sending some assault squads for line of sight. 41-24. Wow, close game so far. Cheeto backing away. Dame. Oh, Staghound. Staghound. Oh, wow. Fluffy sensation. He is indeed a crazy sensation. Not a fluffy sensation. That is, I guess maybe fluffy sensation could mean inside your bed. And he's definitely inside the bed of the Allies forces. Tickled Volta in the places where the sun doesn't shine. Staghound, 6-pounder gun, close range, able to get into position, boom. Cheeto down. Delivers a Staghound to the enemy lines though. That the Cheeto exploded into a ball of flame and is not repairable. That was a fantastic. So many rushes are really changing the game landscape. Two giant things, 3-pounder, sorry, 3 SP, 150mm mortar, and the Cheeto. Devastating losses for Japan. Volta. Now Blackwatch is in position. Some paratroopers guarding the point. They should have it. Another Olicon being bought. And wow, 3.7 by Miss Apples. Interesting buy on this map. Probably wanted to counter the Cheeto, but it's not needed anymore. 24-47. Decent lead by the Anzacs. Score-wise as well. Oh, interesting. It's actually more even than I thought. They're only 20 points up on the score. Staghound, top scorer. Olicon second. All the allies. I'm not sure what did the most damage, because I can't see on the axis. I'm guessing it would have been... I really don't know. I think the infantry, single infantry, has done quite a lot of damage by their flanking and grenades on the emplacements. Now, assault squad, assault squad coming in with the support. We'll be able to dispatch the axis. Volta now sneaking away, trying to save his men to fight another day. And now 3.7, gonna be positioned perhaps right here. There's cover on the right. On the left though, a bit dangerous actually. It's quite close. It can maybe get 50-50'd by a tank from the right. It can't really fire too much down here, I think, because this is that hill. So, Chinu coming from the right. Center, Olicon put straight in on the point, almost. Just needs a bit of guys to cap it. One sneaky guy from Grey Goose over here. Looks like they've banked for it. They've got the veteran Tiger right here. And this is a game changer. But now the 3.7 may have some use. It's got a target worthy of it. It'll be quite hard. It's been pinged though. There's some Japanese troops quite close. Veteran Tiger may go for it. It's facing the wrong way too. If it gets put down, it needs to turn its turret. Veteran Tiger's not going for it. Another 3 SP 150mm mortar would be so handy in this situation for the Axis. Let's see if it has a shot. I think it's a bit too far. Ooh, that side is not... Now it's going to be angled better. Yeah, it's angled 45 degrees. It's going to be hard to penetrate. And it's going to go for the Olicon. What the hell was that? Oh no. Flanked by the Chi-He. That same Chi-He that got repaired. Because there's a Chi-Nu back here. Yeah, that Chi-He got repaired and it... Guys, tell me if that's the same Chi-He that didn't get finished off at the start. Because that's going to change the game. It just took out the 3.7. It's happened too many times in this tournament. Tanks coming back from the dead. It should have been finished off at deciding games time and time again. Now the Tiger's free to play. A bit scared of the 6-pounder. It is quite close. I guess it's fair to not want to risk it. Let's just wait for the house to get knocked down, then finish it off. Fight back from here. Yep. Take the house down. I don't think can penetrate from here. 26-61. Allies hold three flags. One flag held by the Axis. This flag's actually quite easy to hold and take too with that hill. But 6-pounder's, wow, adventurous. Being decrewed, one shot to make it or break it. It won't, it's too far. Knocks down a tree. Veteran Tiger reloads too fast as well. Gonna 45 degree angle it. No problem whatsoever. Taking the shot like a tank. Or like a big, strong tank, I guess, like a battleship. What else can you say? Heji shot return. Boom. Still not finished off, but should be an easy put away next shot. Why isn't he finishing it off? Oh, there you go. The hell was that? I didn't see its turret shoot at it. That was a weird, weird shot. So losing now the northern east and the center, Vet Tiger has definitely shown itself. Ooh, Achilles, risky play, is gonna go try for that side shot, pinged already. Vet Tiger should be facing it's moving, it knows it's there, it's gonna go for it. And it's Miss Apples is caught napping, he doesn't know that the Venom Tiger has spotted him, one shot to put away without even attempting a shot back, misses. Achilles still sleeping. Achilles still napping. Oh, now it's finally turning, gonna return the favor, but it's 45 degree angle at max range. There is absolutely no chance of the Achilles killing it. They're playing a bit safe. Grievous is pulling back because he's scared of some sort of flank. No, it's just a 2-2-2 repaired by Fluffy. Shouldn't have any problems. Let's see his Achilles fall. Oh, it doesn't matter. Tiger doesn't want to go for it. Even the Hargo wants a piece of the action, and its paper thin armor is susceptible for the Hargo, especially at this range. Miss from the Hargo. Achilles waiting for the to line up its shot perfectly. Volta coming out to peek from the shot. That hill's proving to be a bit of a problem. Trying to get it over there just a little bit more. Missing again. Achilles saving its shot for the right moment. Tiger still standing there. Volta with the Hargo. Doesn't want to go further up, waiting. Achilles being repaired. The standoff is happening right here. Type 20 is moving too. Oh no, it doesn't matter. Chini wants action. Why does the Volta go with the other, with the Hargo as well? The same time. Micro definitely not not being used. Oh, bounce on the crew injured only, but the Chinu, can it take it out before it takes out the Chinu? Misses, bounce again, side shot. Easy put away perhaps. Just hull pierce, and there goes a turret. Engine. Oh, attract only. And does take out. It doesn't. Oh, now it does. It's fire. It's flaming. And will burn and explode. Chinu is safe. It can be repaired. So, a loss of an Achilles to nothing. Veteran Tiger was never in danger, though. Didn't catch it by surprise and was always angled and the right way. This same King's African Rifle officer with his Webley. Oh, throwback. Brilliant throwback directly at him. Now he's just got three more guys to kill. They're just recruits, perhaps the Webley can take it. Boom. 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 No. Recruit. Webley guy. Officer. No. Sorry, mate. There you go. Last man of that King's African Rifle goes down. Matador ammo truck towing, 17 pounder, this is an interesting play. Definitely a very desperate one. It's not going to be hard to make it work. 17 pounder, notorious to get one shot. It's big armored plating though. Wow, it's been covered totally by the hay? Is that hay? I don't know. It's actually quite realistic, this hay, isn't it? But 17 pounder, it's giant. Backboard armored plating really attracts those HE shells. Veteran Tiger. Angled? Oh, not really. 17 pounder may take a shot if it stays in that same position. Straight down can take out the Tiger. If it's any gun, it's the gun you want other than the 3.7 to take out the Tiger. It's coming quite close. Though I think there's a hill blocking. Okay, I can't tell. There's a hill here. It's quite an awkward shot, as you can see. It needs to go further down, I think. Now Tiger is coming into kind of an ambush area. Ready for the 17 pounder. Oh, not really, it's a hill. Gonna be a hard shot. Fluffy's waiting patiently. Waiting with bated breath as Grey Goose absorbs the first shot. Veteran Tiger has definitely spotted it. It's been pinged, reversing right now. 17 pounder for another shot. Fluffy sensation misses it. Veteran Tiger's just gonna go for it. It's not angling 45 degrees, it's still facing front. Ooh, now the angle is on, but doesn't matter. It's crew injured, it's very close. And can he put it away, or can the Vet Tiger take it back? Oh, look at that. 17 pounder attracts shells. One shot, easily done. It's like trying to hit a bullseye where the whole dartboard is the bullseye. And Veteran Tiger was actually in quite a risky position and could have been taken out. Bad luck to Fluffy. Fortunately, couldn't couldn't finish that off. Commandos from Fluffy. Now Volta with the 20mm on the middle. Gonna be so hard to counter with that Vet Tiger on the field to protect it. 45 to 71, 30 minutes in. Definitely well fought, I think, by the allies. Volta coming in. Doesn't look like they've got much left in the tank. 4-6-2 to 3-5-3. Now really racking up the kills after the Red and Tiger coming out, putting lots of money into counters, or I wouldn't say counters, I would say hopeful, risky attacks to the Vet Tiger. Achilles, 3.7, 17 pounder, all of them were a bit of a stretch for it to work, but they definitely could have worked, as we saw with the 17 pounder. And this is not looking good at all for the Anzacs. Like I said, it looks like they're going to take this game out very slowly. Though I would say great effort. Well, definitely anyone's game throughout most of it. And doesn't matter. You're a winner anyway. If you lose, whoever gets through will be playing Lobo and Lobo. We haven't seen them for a while. We saw them got demolished by Catch My N in the second round, and just waiting for this game to finish to see who they'll play. Should be another good game, I think. They're pretty much quite evenly skilled. Not the top tier teams, but definitely, I guess, just outside that, above average. And they should be a challenge for both of them. Looking forward to the close game, as this one was very close as well. Dalal rifle, no chance, 20mm, just going to take out all these commandos behind the sandbag as well. Boom, boom, doesn't matter how good you are, or how goodish elite you are. Great weapons, great shooting ability, but 20mm, boom, no way. Need a counter, doesn't look like they'll have one. QF-13 perhaps for the Britcoms, could take out the emplacements. Chinu on the right still. Not long to go, 3-6-2 to 4-8-5, Chihi, wow, Chihi, oh, Chihi takes out the 3.7. Wow, top scorer of the game. Volta having a very good match, doing very well with his tanks. Now Chinu out, so much power on the field. British comms and comms not buying anything. They must be out. The Japanese team is out already of MP. The Brit comms and Great Britain should be out too, because they've lost a lot more. And nothing coming. Capping the back flag again. Perhaps take this one to finish him off. Should be good to see. That's a slow tick down. Tick down. I can't see them coming back. Two pounder, yep, no chance. Perhaps tries to get the HG shell off this, but Chinu's there. Also that Tiger. It's a close game. I don't know what else to say, guys. Just gotta watch this action finish. Massive slugfest. Para's waltzing back in, holding with the skin of his teeth. Some guys using a bit of the hill. I guess that's why the 20mm repositioned. So it has ability to shoot down the guys hiding behind this small incline. Clumsy grenade takes the fence out. And total domination. Pressure. One guy hiding behind here with the Sten silencer. Protecting this two pounder. Ooh, grenade will take out the crew. Chino will finish it off, perhaps. Volta coming in with a shot. Quite a formidable team they are turning out to be. So tournament wise so far looking quite strong. A lot of teams, Catch My N definitely are the favorites, in, I guess, word on the grapevine amongst the competitive players. Catch My N are the ones to beat, taking out Mean Handsy as well at the third round. We definitely want a chance to face them off again, but we have a lot of competition as well to that. Especially versus the European teams, which Catchman did better against European teams than me and Hansy. So even though we we tested Catch My End, we actually do well versus Catch My End. It's just the style of play. Europeans, we find it hard to break them, because they are so defensive and slow down the game so much, and somehow we struggle. I guess with the ping-wise, that slows down the game a bit, makes it easier to play defensive. So we might have to slug it out with the European defense, because we can't micro our way to victory or rushing our way to victory as Catch My End can do versus the Europeans in their good ping. That's my analysis of it anyway. So ticking up ahead, 76-71, should be all over Red Rover very shortly. It's very interesting, there's a whole line of Axis held territory in the center. Spawns right there and the side flags are not Axis. Really holding on, just desperate assault from Miss Apples, just delaying the inevitable. Valiant, I'm gonna call it now, valiant effort. Fluffy's Bizzare Adventure, a run with the two Stooges, took them out quite easily, then met us in a pretty hard game. We beat them 2-0, then they've got down to fight like a sir in the lower bracket, and unfortunately came so close, but no dice. It's all over, Miss Apples. A very desperate assault on that target. Chinu, 20 mil, no chance, mate. So, one team bites the dust. Who else has bit the dust? I haven't looked at it for a while. In the lower bracket, we've lost Randy Boucher. In the lower bracket, round one, we've lost Put It On The Pizza. We've lost This Is Balkans. We've also lost Fight Clan. And, that's it. We've lost two Stooges as well. So quite a few teams have been knocked out, but none of them are the favourites. None of them were considered to be going far in the tournament, so no ups, no big giant upsets yet. So we'll see what happens going on. Pretty much all the top teams are left, and a few other ones like Lobo and Lobo and Like a Sir. Those are the outsiders in this tournament right now. The rest are, I guess, competitive regulars and bound to get far into tournaments. Another rush by Fluffy trying to tee 48 57 millimeter rush, no luck. Tiger is so hard to rush, especially the veteran one. Fires so fast, nearly as fast as a medium tank, or as fast as a medium tank with such accuracy. There's no point. Ammo truck charging in, 89 71. It's all over Red Rover. Bad luck, guys. Hoping you guys will do okay being part of, I guess, the Anzac community. Felled by Like a Sir. Well done to Like a Sir. Grey Goose and Volta, they're pretty much their first tournament they've been in. We'll progress to the lower bracket round three to meet Lobo and Lobo. That is J-Dudes and Booba. Should be a good game. Then further up at the head, I think you'll have either Team North or European Gentlemen finding them, depending on how the ruling goes. With Nat Nat choosing, or Team European Gentlemen choosing Orchard. GG. See you around, guys. I'll just let this tick up. Tick up till it ends. It's going to be the most drawn-out cast ever, isn't it? You can switch off now. Switch off, guys. Switch off now, guys. Alright. GG. And 96-71. 97-98. What? Sniper. He's gonna get outshot by it. Recruits? Almost. He's gonna get outshot by recruits. Hilarious. Oh, that's a reconnaissance sniper. 99-71. Good game to Like a Sir. Well done. We'll see you in the future.